Yo, I'm Travis, and this is Makerholic. This video covers the basic armor plating. I'll be making it to my size, but I'll follow along showing you how to tailor one to your dimensions. Furthermore, the design is unisex. Anyone, any size, can make and wear this costume. Let's get into it. Tools. Exacto blade or scissors. I recommend both. Hot glue or super glue. I prefer hot glue, but quick drying super glue works as well. Slow setting glue works, but obviously takes a lot longer. Measuring tool. I use a tape measure, but anything with inches will do. Un markador. A drill. Or you carefully drill by hand. Materials. A suit jacket. Find one that fits your sides, your chest, and your shoulders well. Don't worry about the arms, because we're cutting them off later. Faux leather coat. I get mine from the thrift shop. The bigger the better, it's mainly for scrap material. Cardboard. Make sure it's undamaged. Holes and bumps will look bad later. Thick string. Preferably leather cording, but paracord or thick twine would also work. The spalders are a single piece of shoulder armor. Mine are 10 inches by 6.5 inches. You need two of these. To make them your size, measure your shoulders from below the collarbone to the scapula, like so. Next, measure from your neck to your shoulder, like so, and use these numbers to make your spalders. The rib braces are double-plated upper arm armor. Mine are about 9 inches by 4.5 inches. You need four of these. To make them your size, measure about two-thirds the way around your upper arm. Next, measure from your forearm to your armpit and add 1 inch to that number, then divide it by 2. Use these numbers to make your rear braces. The gauntlets are more complicated. I'll show you how to make this design. Draw an 11.5 inch line horizontally, then bisect it vertically with a 9 inch line. 6 inches of the vertical line are below the horizontal line, and 3 inches are above it. Next, mark 4 inches out from the base in both directions. Finally, connect the dots and voila! If you want to make it larger or smaller, you can easily adjust the design now. To make them your size, measure your upper arm to your wrist. That is your length. Change the design's length to match yours and adjust the angled top accordingly. For smaller sizes, bring the sides in like this. For larger ones, extend them before cutting. Make sure it's snug on the forearms, touches evenly in the middle, and allows full wrist movement. Now the jacket. Remove the sleeves and the seam that runs long ways. Use a seam ripper if you have one. Use an Exacto blade like this. Lay the material flat and line up 2 rear braces, 1 spalter, and 1 gauntlet, half the armor pieces. The gauntlet must be on the cuff end so it has the buttons. Try to line the buttons up in the middle of the gauntlet. Then outline the pieces, cut them out, and do this with both sleeves, enough for all 8 pieces of plate armor. Next, bend the cardboard like so, with at least 1 bend every 1/2 inch when you're done. Be as consistent as possible. You want a smooth curve. Sometimes I use a board for precision. Bend the spalders and the rear braces short ways once. The gauntlets must be bent twice or else they end up like this. I use the board for precision. They should look like this once they're done. Now, get your hot glue gun. I already glued the other side. Notice how I pull the fabric taut before gluing. Do this or you get wrinkles. I usually glue a side in segments to help avoid wrinkling. Once all sides are glued, trim excess material off the corners. I like to touch up the glue job. It's stronger and looks nicer. Next, we need faux leather for trim. Remove the sleeves from your leather coat and set them aside. They'll be made into leggings in a later video. You'll notice my coat is already disassembled. I forgot to film it. Cut up the body for trim strips. I'll do a rear brace piece first. Cut out 2 1¼-inch by 9.5-inch strips and 2 1¼-inch by 5-inch strips. The lengths are approximate. I add about 1/2 inch to the length of the side that the piece is going to go on. Choose a side to start with and line up the materials. Then glue it like so. Flip it over and draw a line just before the edge of the leather. Use this to guide the glue. Be precise. Mistakes are hard to fix here, and materials are limited. Do all four sides, then clean up the corners and use the glue to seal them up like so. Now, repeat this process for the remaining three rear bracers and two spalders. Now, the gauntlets. First, glue the straight end with the cuff, then start at the opposite side. Notice how I cut the fabric at the top and pull it tight before gluing. I can't stress this enough, wrinkles will ruin the look. Once the top is glued tight, tighten and glue the sides on. Lovely. Now, cut a 1.5 inch by 5 inch piece of leather and cut the corners as I did. Mark the center of the buttons, then slice it long ways. Then cut several smaller slits lined up with the button marks. It was tricky getting it to fit. Make sure it's fairly flush. Then mark your path and glue it down. Again, I highly recommend using the marker.
Talking about dang old quality for quantity, man.
As you can see, it's fairly flush. And next is the leather trim. Cut a 1.25 inch by 8.5 inch strip for the side by the buttons, and a 1.25 inch by 14 inch strip for the other side with the angle. For the longer piece, I glued 1/2, then I cut a small triangle at the peak to make it fairly flush. Cut 3 inch by 7.5 inch pieces for the sides, with 1 inch on the inside and 2 inches on the outside. Mark 7 dots, 1 inch apart, and at least 5 inches deep. The hole should go through the leather material on both sides. Repeat the process on the other half, and you're ready to lace them up, looking good. And that's part one. We've made 8 pieces of armor. Next time, we'll work on the belts to strap them in, as well as the vest. This is my channel's first video, and I am stoked! I have project giveaways planned, video podcasts, respond to questions, featuring top commenters. My goal is to build a community around my projects, and I would love to have you along. To kick things off, I'm gonna write my first subscriber's name on my work table right here. Got a spot for you, buddy. If you like my music, check out a link. Thanks for watching. See you next time.